There's the trio known as the Shield. Dean Ambrose, the United States champion, leading the way, followed by Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns. It's been an incredible 2013 for the Shield. What a presence by this group. And we have a series of matches coming up here on Friday Night SmackDown. And John Cena started the night tonight trying to spread some holiday cheer before the Shield got involved.
Well, anytime you have a holiday party, people show up. The Shield show up. Mark Henry showed up. Big E showed up. And Corpus, we had a problem.
And then, of course, the director of operations, Kane, came down and made three matches, major matches for tonight.
The following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, weighing in at 225 pounds. Representing the Shield, he is the United States Champion, Dean Ambrose.
Dean Ambrose set to face the Intercontinental Champion right now.
And his opponent, from Tampa, Florida, weighing in at 285 pounds, he is the Intercontinental Champion, Big E.
Big E Langston will face that man, Dean Ambrose. But he's got some backup.
He got a lot of backup.
Mark Henry will face Roman Reigns in the second in a series of three matches tonight. That's going to be a collision. And the third man in the equation. John Cena, who later on takes on Seth Rollins. Opportunities abound here tonight. John Cena upset, of course, because he was ball by the Shield when he kicked off SmackDown tonight. Langston and Henry would then get involved, allowing Kane to make these matches.
And you gotta say, the director of operations has done a wonderful job.
So John, first match out of the box, the United States Champion Dean Ambrose against the Intercontinental Champion Big E Langston. It was a interesting article on WWE.com this week. They talked about it on the WWE app during the commercial break. Langston and his power, along with Dean Ambrose, were asked what they think would happen if both the Intercontinental title and United States Championship were unified, much like the WWE title and world title were recently. Big E Langston said losing the Intercontinental Championship would be a bad thing because it's always been around in WWE. Said we shouldn't lose that title because of the history. Dean Ambrose said the Intercontinental Championship was always referred to as the workhorse title. Here's the cover on Langston because it was defended more feverishly. However, he said, look, right now, the United States Championship, I've defended that thing on four continents and more countries than I can remember. And he said unification would be a good thing as long as they made one good-looking championship that I could haul along.
I think Dean's short of any confidence.
Ambrose again looking to put Langston away and a kick out at two. See John Cena over the corner of your screen trying to get the WWE fans into this thing.
I don't think the WWE Universe needs much prodding to get into this. You got the Intercontinental versus United States Champion.
Ambrose, the eccentric one of the Shield. Very unorthodox style. And for Langston, it's flat-out power. And that's just an example there for the former powerlifting champion.
Shield, the breakout star of 2013. Big E can be the breakout star of 2014.
Off a belly-to-belly suplex, and now Big E Langston, his 300-pound frame, splashing Ambrose.
What a meteoric rise this young man has seen lately.
Big E Langston, I think Jada is a future world champion. And there's a shrewd move by Ambrose.
I couldn't agree with you more.
Rollins and Reigns stalking Langston, and Cena and Mark Henry. Gonna make sure that doesn't happen. Referee John Cone trying to keep the peace here. Dean Ambrose said, welcome to the main event, Big E.
Roman Reigns took a little exception at that push-up by Dean Ambrose. Uh-oh!
Straps down! Big ending! Big E Langston picks up the victory!
What a huge win! Oh, here we go!
It's going to be time now for the Shield to regroup. Because Mark Henry gets his hands on Roman Reigns when we return to Friday Night SmackDown here on Sci-Fi. And we are back on Friday Night SmackDown. So Big E Langston gives his team, so to speak, a 1-0 lead in this series of matches tonight. Big E knocked off Dean Ambrose moments ago, and this is going to be an amazing, amazing match. Talk about power, Roman Reigns and Mark Henry.
As the great Gorilla would say, the unstoppable force against the immovable object.
I thought Reigns was actually going to try the test of strength against the world's strongest man.
Reigns is a big powerhouse. The problem is that guy right across from him is the strongest man in the world.
Bam! Oh, man. The power of Henry. You know, we saw Mark Henry having fun this past Monday night on Raw, John, as good Santa. Mark loves to have a good time, but on nights like these where the chips are down, Mark Henry is all business. And Roman Reigns, it's not often that this man is outpowered in WWE, but that could be the case tonight.
Mark wasn't all business when he had to save Christmas.
He was having fun.
Mark may be having fun right now.
Driving Reigns into the apron, kidney first. Crawls to the cover, and Reigns doesn't even allow the referee to get into position when he kicks out. Rollins looks on, he gets John Cena next.
Come on, big man. Little mind games. We don't even allow the referee to get to a one count.
This Roman Reigns, I think, is going to be a major, major star. Oh, and Mark Henry, former world champion in his own right.
Well, Roman Reigns is part of the group that was the breakout stars of the year, faction of the year.
You said before you don't ever recall a trio bursting on the scene like the Shield has.
Look, I can't remember. You talk about the NWO, which I think it's hard to parallel these guys.
Wow! Is this enough to put Henry away? Roman Reigns hooks the big tree trunk-like leg, and Henry kicks out.
The Freebirds in Dallas, Four Horsemen, DX. I'd put the Shield up there with all of them. And the Shield did it in their debut year.
And now Reigns starts to use his power, his body weight, wearing Henry down. Great move by Reigns to keep Henry off his feet here. Take the power game away from the world's strongest man. What is it that Roman Reigns brings to the table, John?
Well, Roman Reigns brings a combination of power and athleticism. And he's got to use that to keep Mark Henry, exactly what you just said, Michael, off his feet.
And Henry.
Look, Mark Henry wasn't just a little bit strong.
He was a strike right there.
He was the strongest man in the world.
And now Mark Henry with a shoulder tackle. It's like running into a truck.
Or the truck running into you.
Mark Henry having some fun, paying homage to the Hall of Famer, the late, great Junkyard Dog. 400 plus pounds. Roman Reigns slips from behind. And look at the power of Reigns into the Samoan drop.
That is strength.
That Superman punch. And now Roman Reigns is dominating Mark Henry.
Roman Reigns setting up that spear. Can he hit it with
and
a big man?
Spear to Henry.
I got it.
Roman Reigns with a spear to Mark Henry. And this one's over.
What a huge victory for Roman Reigns. This guy is something special.
Wow.
There's that Superman punch. That is incredible.
And this is incredible as well. Spear to Mark Henry. Major spear from Roman Reigns.
And beat the world's strongest man right in the middle of the ring. That was impressive.
So now it's Seth Rollins' turn. He goes one-on-one with John Cena next on SmackDown. And we are back on Friday Night SmackDown. It is John Cena one-on-one with Seth Rollins of The Shield. Big E Langston beat Dean Ambrose. Then Roman Reigns knocked off Mark Henry. This is the third in our series of main event matchups set up by our Director of Operations, Kane, earlier tonight. John Cena against the highly athletic Seth Rollins. What does Rollins have to do, John, to take out Cena here?
Rollins has an unorthodox style, that high-flying style that I'm not sure that John Cena has seen a lot of in the last couple years. It's going to be very hard to surprise a 14-time world champion in John Cena, but that's what Seth Rollins needs to do. Look, it's an uphill battle. I think Seth Rollins can do it, but I think it would be an upset if he did.
Here's Seth Rollins, nice leapfrog by John Cena. Cena with a hip toss to Rollins. And now Seth Rollins looks to regroup. You know, we talked about this earlier tonight on SmackDown, John. The big news coming from Monday Night Raw that on January 20th, the Animal Batista, the six-time world champion, returns to WWE. I bring that up because Cena and Batista were involved in one of the most exciting Royal Rumble matches in history back in 2005, the night we had to go to overtime before Batista took out Cena.
Well, they both hit the floor at exactly the same time. Had to go into sudden death at the Royal Rumble.
Can't wait to see why Batista's returning to WWE, why he picked this moment in time as Cena pounds away on Seth Rollins.
Hey, I'm just glad he picked the time. It's gonna be so great to have Batista back.
And this could be what Seth Rollins needs right here. John Cena floored after he goes shoulder first into the turnbuckle. I like this Seth Rollins. He has all the tools, quick as they come. Technically sound, high flyer.
He certainly does, and this is a great test for Seth Rollins. You don't get any better than John Cena. And that first time you're in one of these really big matches like this, you find out a little something about guys.
Come on now. Come on, John. Seth Rollins does not lack confidence. None of the members of the Shield do.
Come on, John.
No, Seth has been in some big matches. As a team, they've been in some big matches you could possibly be in. As a single, he has been in some big ones. This is a huge test tonight.
John Cena. Talk about big matches. Maybe the biggest pressure player in the history of WWE. A couple of weeks ago, tables, ladders, and chairs versus Randy Orton, the night that Randy Orton went on to win the WWE World Heavyweight title. Rollins looks for a major win and a kick out by Cena.
Years ago, Rob Ori was called Big Shot Rob because Rob Ori found ways to win championship games. John Cena is much the same. He finds ways to deliver when the lights are on brightest.
Rob Ori, of course, gaining that name when he played with the Rockets in Houston during their championship run. Now John Cena trying to power out of this, but now Rollins has got him right down to the mat. Seth Rollins doing a great job neutralizing John Cena here. surprise, and I would think the slower pace would benefit Cena, but Rollins is doing a nice job with it.
Rollins has got a great game plan so far. So one thing the Shield does very well is get a game plan and stick to it.
Langston has a win tonight over Ambrose, looking on. John Cena trying to create separation, and he does there, but has the damage been done? Now, ooh, again, right to the mush. Seth Rollins.
Seth Rollins has a 14-time champion, Reeland.
Here's the cover. This would be a major win for Rollins, perhaps the biggest win of Seth Rollins' career. Rollins and Reigns held the WWE Tag Team titles earlier this year.
And only thanks to Big Show did they lose those championships to the Rhodes Brothers.
And Rollins off the neck breaker. To the cover, hook of the leg on Cena. Cena powers out. We're coming back with more. And we are back on Friday Night SmackDown in the middle of an incredible main event. Seth Rollins of the Shield taking on John Cena. And John, are you surprised at the way that Seth Rollins has completely dictated the pace of this match?
Yeah, completely controlled the flow of the match. Seth Rollins came in here with a game plan and has executed it perfectly.
Talking trash to Henry and Langston at ringside.
Not sure how wise that is to take time away from the 14-time world champion and talk a little trash, but Seth Rollins feels like it's appropriate.
And Rollins is, can I use the word, dominating John Cena?
Believe it or not, so far Seth Rollins is.
Reigns and Ambrose perilously close to Cena. See, Reigns is playing psychological games with Cena, saying you're just going to have to give up, Cena.
I don't think that's going to happen.
Nah, it's hard to get in the head of John Cena. Been through way too many wars in his career. Rollins, and this could be the turning point for Cena. At least Cena buys himself some time. And now Henry and Langston and the WWE fans trying to get Cena back into this match. It's been all Rollins at this juncture. And this is what Rollins had to be afraid of. Maybe not. Rollins plants Cena face first.
Great counter.
Cena was going for the side slam, and Rollins countered. Can he put Cena away? Is Cena stunned enough in a near fall for Rollins of the Shield?
What a great counter by Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins has had John Cena game plan perfectly.
Now Rollins mocking Cena with Cena's trademark, "You can't see me." Confidence is growing for Rollins as this matchup continues. Cena, reverse. And now he's got Rollins where he wants him. And now the five knuckles shuffle to Seth Rollins. Cena looking for the attitude adjustment. Rollins up on his shoulders, and John Cena. And Rollins laid it on his feet.
Another great counter
and
by
an
Seth.
And elbow right to the nose. This could be over. Rollins. Pinning combination on Cena. Hook to the leg, and Cena stays in it.
Talk about great athleticism. John Cena goes for that AA. Seth Rollins lands on his feet. Makes another terrific counter.
Listen to the WWE fans here at Corpus. Rollins right to Cena. Cena again down. John Cena had a flurry. He was making a comeback, and just like this, Seth Rollins has regained control.
Matches like this can be career-defining moments. We wondered if Seth Rollins would be able to step up. He certainly is.
Listen to Reigns still talking trash to Cena.
You gotta love the confidence of somebody like Seth Rollins.
Cena sidestepping Rollins, bounces head first off the turnbuckle. Now John Cena. Oh man, what a neck breaker by Cena. Here's the cover, hook to the leg on Rollins. Oh man, he stayed in it. He stayed in it. Cena thought it was three, but Rollins just at 2 3/4, got his shoulder up.
What a match we're seeing on SmackDown. This is incredible.
Cena thought it was a three count.
What a huge night for Seth Rollins.
Cena telling the referee to warn the Shield to stay away as he goes up to the top rope. Cena looking for the final blow to put, oh, and Rollins!
Another great counter.
And Cena, I believe he caught the back of his leg on the top rope, or his groin perhaps. And now Seth Rollins. Oh man! Is that enough for Seth Rollins to pull a huge upset? Cena powered out. Reigns and Ambrose thought he had him.
We knew going into this that Seth Rollins could beat John Cena, but that would it be an upset doing so. I don't think anybody dreamed that Seth Rollins would take it to John Cena like this.
Cena trying to make it back to his feet, but Rollins continues on offense. Near fall after near fall for both of these superstars. And now it's Cena. John Cena. Tremendous move. Seth Rollins up top. Rollins is fighting through this thing now.
That is strength.
Flat out power by Cena. John Cena. He's got it. No, Rollins stayed in again. Another near fall for John Cena.
Rollins knows this is the biggest single match of his career so far. And he's leaving every bit of it in the ring.
Cena can't believe that Seth Rollins kicked out. I thought Cena had him.
I love it when you see a great superstar like this step up in a big match. We knew John Cena would. We figured that Seth Rollins would, and he did.
Rollins up top, AA time, but he manages to grab the top rope. And now Cena. Oh, what a move by Rollins! He's just an incredible athlete. Can Rollins capitalize? He caught Cena on the side of the head. Rollins gonna try to crawl to the cover in the biggest win of his singles career. Cover, wraps the arm, hooks the leg, and again a near fall for Rollins. This move here is incredible, John.
Yes, it is. What incredible athleticism that Seth Rollins possesses.
There are a number of occasions in this match that both these superstars thought they had won. What does Rollins do now? He's hit Cena with everything he has.
Stick with your game plan. It's working so far. You just hadn't found a way to beat him. But you're dominating the match.
Up top, knee caught Cena.
That may have done it.
Again, a cover. Wrap the arm this time, and again, John Cena manages to stay in it. Rollins can't afford to get frustrated.
Most people, when they get in that ring with John Cena for the first time, get very frustrated. They don't realize how resilient the 14-time champion is. There's a reason he's been the guy in the WWE for the last 10 years.
Big moment in this match. Seth Rollins. John Cena caught him. John Cena picked the leg. Cena going for the STF. STF locked in for Cena. Rollins smartly gets to the ropes before Cena can get fully in position.
That's right. Before Cena can lock it in, Rollins knew enough.
And now Langston making sure that Ambrose couldn't get involved and ruin this great matchup.
Come on, John. Oh.
And there's Roman Reigns. Shoulders, what a move to the AA! John Cena wins!
Big game, John!
Here's your winner, John Cena!
But don't take anything away from Seth Rollins! What an incredible match! What an incredible way to end 2013 on SmackDown! Man, Seth Rollins proved that he belonged tonight, John.
Did he ever. What a great performance by Seth Rollins.
Look at the action toward the end of this matchup. Biggie Langston makes sure Dean Ambrose can't ruin a great match. And then watch what Mark Henry does to, after Roman Reigns takes out Biggie Langston.
Look at the shot that Dean Ambrose takes while Roman's boot.
Rollins looking to put Cena away. Cena rolls completely through, powers Rollins up to his shoulders. And in the move that made him famous, the patented attitude adjustment. And John Cena picks up the win.
WWE's version of Big Shot Rob.
And unbelievable.